one of the parts of your body that will be touched. Whenever God wants to use you, it's your mouth. The Holy Spirit will speak to your mouth. But before God can speak to your mouth, your tongue must be touched in the realm of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit is speaking at all time. The Holy Spirit is a speaking spirit. This spirit can never stop speaking. In Isaiah chapter 6 verse 8, Isaiah said, "Also, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Then said I, here am I, send me. Then said I, behold, here I am, send me. Here am I, send me." I heard the voice of the Lord. So the voice of the Lord is the voice of the Holy Spirit, the speech of the Holy Spirit for this generation. The Holy Spirit is the best orator in every generation. He is the best orator in our kingdom. And the kingdom of light is the kingdom of the best orators. Because we have the voice of the Holy Spirit, which is at work in the kingdom of light, the Holy Spirit forms vocal sounds per time. Your ears must be open to dictate the voice of the Holy Spirit. Your ears must be open in the realm of the Spirit to receive the voice of the Holy Spirit so that you can speak out the words of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of the Lord is calling per time, and is drawing men towards Christ. The Spirit is calling many into the work of the ministry. It's calling per time. In Genesis chapter 3, right in the Garden of Eden, Adam and his wife heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. Their ears were open to perceive the steps of God. These steps of God represent the steps of the Spirit of God. So it was the Spirit of God that was moving in the garden. The Spirit of God was moving in the garden. This same Spirit was able to locate Moses for the work of the ministry. The voice of God spoke out of the midst of fire. And Moses was able to pick this voice. And immediately his life was transformed. He received power through the voice of the Holy Spirit. Ezekiel saw in his vision the voice of the speech of God. So in the realm of the Spirit, he heard the noise of wings of angels, like the noise of great waters in Ezekiel chapter 1. Just as the voice of the Almighty, the voice of speech, as the voice of an host, the voice of speech of God. So he saw the angel of the presence of God with the voice of the speech of God. The moment you can pick this voice, your life will be transformed. The voice of the Almighty God speaking to every generation. There is a word for this generation. And if you can pick that word, you will transform your generation. God is waiting for someone to pick that word. Because God is still speaking to us as he spoke to our fathers in the old dispensation. and in the past generation. God is speaking to us, He's touching many tongues, and He's giving direction by the voice of the Holy Spirit. By the voice of the Holy Spirit, we have the voice, we have the voice to do wonders in this generation. Do you know that this voice of the Holy Spirit is making intercession for the church with groanings that cannot be uttered? Groanings that cannot be uttered. You cannot perceive it with your physical ears, but you can perceive these groanings with your spiritual ears. Your physical senses cannot pick these groanings, but your spiritual senses can pick these groanings. Man was made in the image of God and after the likeness of God, so that he can exercise the dominion mandate on it. Man must exercise the dominion mandate on it. And one of the ways by which we can exercise this dominion mandate is by engaging the mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit in everyday affairs of man. The voice of the Holy Spirit. The voice of the Holy Spirit is the key. The voice of the Holy Spirit is the key to victory. Is the key to victory. The moment you have that voice, you can control every other voices. You can control all other voices. The moment you have the voice of the Holy Spirit, the moment you can pick the voice of the Holy Spirit, you can control all the languages in the world. All the languages in the world. Because we receive our calling into the work of the ministry by engaging this voice. Although Paul was the least among the saints, but because of the grace of God upon him, he received the voice of the Holy Spirit and his life was transformed. He was able to reveal unto humanity the unsearchable riches of Christ just because he was able to pick the voice of the Holy Spirit located him, and his life was changed. The utterances of the Holy Spirit touched him. So inside of Paul, he was carrying another tongue, the divine tongue. He could hear the whistle and the whisper of the Holy Spirit per time. The Holy Spirit was revealing unto him the revelation knowledge for the time. And he was putting them down and teaching his generation the revelation knowledge of God. Your ears must be open to hear the shout of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes the Holy Spirit will roar at you. The Holy Spirit will roar at you in order to give you spectacular directions. The Spirit will roar at you. The Spirit is blowing trumpets, and you must be able to pick the sound of this trumpet. The noise of the Holy Spirit is in the kingdom, making echoes. The Holy Spirit is making echoes, different noises, and you should be able to pick it so that you can make good decisions per time. The interest of the Holy Spirit must be your interest. The wish of the Holy Spirit must be your wish. And you can only discover this if you are not dumb and deaf. Many people are spiritually dumb and deaf. So you must open your ears. Open your ears, your spiritual perception, so that you can dictate the things of the Spirit. You dictate the things of the Spirit. But there are many implications and applications of this mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit. What then are the implications and the application? In the book of Matthew chapter 10, starting from verse 19 to 20, he said, but when they deliver you up, that was Jesus speaking to his disciples, take no thought how or what ye shall speak, for it shall be given you in that same hour what ye shall speak. It shall be given unto you in that same hour what ye shall speak. How? In verse 20, for it is not ye that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. The Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. So there is a Spirit that will speak in you. That Spirit will bring unto you what you shall speak. As God be with the mouth of Moses and Aaron, so that they can speak the right thing. In Exodus chapter 4, their mouths were empowered to release the right word, the word of power, the word of wisdom, the word of revelation and revolution for their generation. So your mouth must be touched. Your mouth must be touched. Prophet Jeremiah saw his mouth being touched. Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And Lord said unto me, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. The Lord touched the mouth of Prophet Jeremiah in Jeremiah chapter 1. By the mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit. So your mouth must be touched. Your mouth must be touched to reveal the right word for your generation. The word of transformation for your generation. So one unique thing about the Holy Spirit, the voice of the Holy Spirit, is that this voice has a speaking ability. Can you write? The voice has a speaking ability. That is the first point. So the moment you receive the voice of the Holy Spirit, you receive this speaking ability. You receive a speaking ability. You will be strengthened. Your mouth will be strengthened. Your voice will be strengthened. Because you are carrying another voice inside of you. This is the voice of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of the Lord God spake by David, and his word was in his tongue. His word was in his tongue. The Spirit of the Lord God spoke by David. So David was able to build generals because of a voice inside of him, not his own voice. That means whenever David opened his mouth to speak out, the voice of the Holy Spirit will always echo out of his mouth. The voice of the Holy Spirit will be released out of his mouth. You vocalize the things of the Spirit. You pronounce the things of heaven on earth. And you express the mind of God on earth. Because the voice of the Holy Spirit is the mind of God. So you are speaking out the mind of God on it. Because we are gods on it. You utter the things of God on it. And you communicate the mandate of heaven on it. You talk out the senses of God. You speak out the wisdom of God and converse the things of God. So that means you are the orator of God on it. As you are the oracles of God on it, you are the orators of God on it. You are speaking for God on it. God will do wonders on it. But God will not come down to do it himself. God will do wonders on it. But God will not come down to do these wonders himself. He will use men to do wonders. The Spirit of God is in us, and we have the voice of God to do wonders, so that we can deliver the message of God in our word, and we lecture our word, the things of God, we lecture them. We are to lecture them. We teach them the things of God on earth. So this voice of the Holy Spirit is one of the greatest gifts given by our Heavenly Father to the church. We have the greatest gift. In Luke chapter 21 verse 15 it says, "For I will give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist." A mouth and wisdom, a mouth and wisdom by the voice of the Holy Spirit. By the voice of the Holy Spirit. So on the day of Pentecost, the disciples of Jesus were filled with the Holy Ghost, and they began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. The Spirit gave them utterance. So they were able to perceive the voice of the Spirit. So it was the Spirit of God that was giving them this utterance. They received utterance through the voice of the Spirit. They were able to speak with wisdom that no man on earth could resist. No man on earth could resist this wisdom. No man on earth could resist this wisdom. So it is impossible for the word to resist your speech. It is impossible. This speech is the word of the Holy Spirit. This speech is the voice of the Holy Spirit. So you are speaking out the voice of the Holy Spirit. In Acts of the Apostles chapter 7, there was a man called Stephen who was full of the Holy Ghost. Full of the Holy Ghost. And he was able to resist the philosophers in those days. He was able to resist the philosophers in the days of the Acts of the Apostles. He saw the heavens opened unto him by the voice of the Holy Spirit. So none of the philosophers could resist him. None of the philosophers could withstand him, because he was carrying the voice of the Holy Spirit. He was speaking out the things of God on earth. He was teaching the revelation knowledge of God on earth. The revelation knowledge of God on earth. Do you know that the angels in heaven were even jealous of this voice? Peter saw this mystery, that angels in heaven are jealous of the voice of the Holy Spirit that is in the church. Angels are jealous of the gospel. We cannot preach the gospel without the voice of the Holy Spirit. In 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 12, it says, "But unto us they did minister the things which are now reported unto you by them that have preached the gospel unto you with the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven, which things the angels desire to look into." The angels desire to look into it. So the gospel of salvation is a product of the voice of the Holy Spirit. For prophecy, the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but only men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. They spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. So your Heavenly Father knows that you have need of some things on it, and that Heavenly Father will give those things through the voice of the Holy Spirit. You receive the speaking ability. The kingdom of Christ is the kingdom of excellent orators. You are an orator on it. You can speak the mind of God on it. You have the ability in you to speak the things of God on earth. To speak the things of God on earth. You are a good orator, excellent orator, because you have the voice of the Spirit. The voice is speaking to you, the speaking ability. That is the first thing that God will give to you. God will always give to every leader the speaking ability. If you cannot speak, you cannot become a leader in your world. We are the light of the world. A city that is set on an hill can never be hid. This kingdom is a kingdom of leaders. We are to lead. And we can lead by this wonderful instrument, the instrument of speaking, the instrument of speaking. So God will give you the mantle of speaking, the mantle of good oration, the mantle of excellent oration. So when you speak, man begins to cry. When you speak, people begins to cry, because you have the speaking anointing. This speaking anointing is by the voice of the Holy Spirit. John the Baptist did not perform any miracle, but God gave unto him the speaking ability. The speaking ability, you need it. It is by the voice of the Holy Spirit. This is by the voice of the Holy Spirit. Are we together, please? Are we together, please? Let your mind be here. Please focus your mind on this pulpit, please. The speaking ability is the first thing that you will receive by the mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit. The most lucrative gift in this world is the gift of public speaking. If you can speak and convince men, you will rule your world. I bet it with you. I'm not joking, please. If you can speak and convince your word, you will rule your word. You speak to convince men, and you also speak to confuse your enemies. You will rule your word. The speaking ability of the Holy Spirit is by the mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit. And when you have the voice of the Holy Spirit, you have this speaking ability. The moment you can perceive that voice, you have this speaking ability in you. In Isaiah chapter 30 verse 21, Isaiah says, "And thy ears shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it, when ye turn to the right hand, and when ye turn to the left." Thy ears, not just one ear, thy two ears, shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way. So the Holy Spirit has a guiding ability. Can you write? The voice of the Holy Spirit has a guiding ability. So that is the second implication and application of the mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit. The guiding ability. The voice of the Holy Spirit will guide you to the right way. Because the voice of the Holy Spirit is the pilot of our destiny. The voice of the Holy Spirit is the pilot of our jet and the captain of our life. This voice is the sailor of the ship of the kingdom, our pathfinder, our escort and convoy. The Holy Spirit will carry us from one realm to another realm. And as we move from one realm to another realm, in the realm of the Spirit, we shall be able to do wonders on earth. Everything on earth is spiritual. Please take note of this. Everything on earth is spiritual. Life is spiritual. So every physical manifestation is as a result of a spiritual manipulation. So the Holy Spirit will help you to manipulate things in the realm of the Spirit so that you can receive the manifestations in this physical world. So by the guiding ability of the voice of the Holy Spirit, you are launched from one level to another level, from one step to another step, from one height to another height by the ministry of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will direct you, as the Spirit is directing the church right now. The Holy Spirit will direct us in the path of righteousness and holiness. The path of righteousness and holiness. The Spirit will guide us into the highways of God and deliver us from the crooked and perverse ways, so that we can walk on the straight path of God. The Holy Spirit, being our Redeemer, is ready to lead us and teach us to profit, to lead us in the way that we should go. There is a way we must go in every circumstances of our life. There is a particular way we must go. There is a particular way we must go in every circumstances of our life. So the Holy Spirit will teach us and lead us in this way, because the Spirit is our leader. He is the guru. He is the guru in the kingdom right now, the explorer in the kingdom, our conductor. And this Spirit will usher us into a new movement through the guiding ability of the voice of the Holy Spirit. We are being ushered into a new movement because the Spirit is the pioneer of the church, the chaperon. You know, whenever you are writing an exam, there will be a chaperon beside you. A chaperon beside you. Chaperon is used in medical practice. You see a chaperon standing beside a doctor. So the Holy Spirit is the chaperon of this kingdom, because the Spirit will always stand beside you in every examination of life. The Spirit is your chaperon, the superintendent of the church, the model and the pattern that we should follow, is the designer of our life and is giving examples that we should follow. So the Spirit will guide us through the circumstances of life. By every circumstances of life, the psalmist said in Psalm 143 verse 10, teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God, thy spirit is good. Lead me into the land of uprightness. The psalmist said, lead me into the land of uprightness. Lead me into the land of uprightness. So you have to trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding, and in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. He will definitely direct your path through the voice of the Holy Spirit. So the voice is able to direct, and the voice is ready. So the voice is speaking per time. You know, man will speak and stop speaking for a while, but the Holy Spirit has never stopped speaking. The Holy Spirit is speaking every moment, every time, every season. But can you perceive that voice? The Holy Spirit is just speaking without stopping. Speaking without stopping. That is the operation of the Spirit. The Spirit is just speaking, just speaking. Hallelujah. Just speaking without stopping. So you have the unction of that Holy One, and you know all things, because the Spirit will guide you into all things. The anointing that you have received abides in you forever, and this anointing will help you to perceive the voice of the Holy Spirit. And by perceiving it, this Spirit will guide you into all things. This same anointing of the Holy Spirit will guide you. The voice of the Holy Spirit will guide you into all things, both on your right hand and on your left hand. The voice is ready to guide you. This same voice guided Moses. This same voice guided Aaron. This same voice guided Joshua. This same voice guided Gideon in the old dispensation. So if you can have this voice, you will become a leader in your generation. You just need a voice to become a leader. This voice is the presence of God in our life. The voice is the presence of God. So when you turn to your right hand, or when you turn to your left hand, the Spirit is still speaking. The Spirit can direct you so that you can pass through many paths in order to fulfill your destiny on it. The psalmist said in Psalm 32 verse 8, I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way which thou shalt go. I will guide thee with my eyes. I will guide thee with my eyes. I will guide thee with my eyes. So you should be able to perceive it. Do you know that all the bodies, all the parts of the body of God are full of ears? We have ears all over the bodies of God. So all the parts of the body of the Holy Spirit, every part of the body of the Holy Spirit is full of mouth. So the Holy Spirit is speaking from every part of his body. Every part of his body is speaking. So every part of our body also contains ears. In the realm of the spirit, our human spirit is carrying many ears, not just two ears. Our human spirit is carrying many ears, not just the two ears. Do you know that there are ears in our eyes in the realm of the spirit? There are ears in our nose in the realm of the spirit. There are ears in our leg in the realm of the spirit. So there are ears attached to our legs in the realm of the spirit. So all our spirit man carries ears. So every part of our body in the realm of the spirit is carrying ears, so that we can perceive the voice of the Holy Spirit, not just the two ears. We have many ears, so that we can perceive the voice of the Spirit. So the Spirit of God is our vanguard, our advance guide, our forerunner, a precursor that is guiding us. The precursor will guide you into the process. The precursor will spearhead every movement. So the Holy Spirit will spearhead every movement in our world. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. I just pray that your eyes be open to see what I can see. I pray that your ears be open to receive this mystery. And I pray that your mind be enlarged to carry this mystery. Your mind be enlarged to carry this mystery. In John chapter 16 verse 13, Gospel of John chapter 16 verse 13, Jesus said, how be it when the Spirit of truth is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. The Spirit will guide you into all truth. So the Spirit will not only guide you, but the Spirit will guide you into all truth. The Spirit is ready to guide you into all things. Do you know that we have fivefold ministries? The ministry of the apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, and teachers. So the Holy Spirit will guide you into your calling on earth, so that you can fulfill your calling on earth. The Spirit will guide you into your calling, so that you can fulfill your calling on earth. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, starting from verse 10, it said, but God has revealed these mysteries unto us by his Spirit, for the Spirit searcheth all things, Yea, the deep things of God, the Spirit searcheth all things. Yea, the deep things of God, the Spirit will guide you into the deep mysteries of God. Not the superficial mysteries. There are superficial mysteries on earth. But God will reveal unto you the deep mysteries on earth, not the superficial mysteries. So for you to do exploits on earth, you need the deep mysteries of God, not just the superficial mysteries. For you to operate just like God on earth, you need the deep mysteries of God. Joel, Prophet Joel, in Joel chapter 2 verse 28, he says, "And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions." You see, so your young sons and your sons and daughters shall prophesy. They shall prophesy the things of the Spirit. They shall prophesy through the mystery of the voice of the Spirit. So by the mystery of the voice of the Spirit, sons and daughters shall prophesy. Young men and young women shall see visions. Through the voice of the Holy Spirit, they shall see vision. And through the voice of the Holy Spirit, old men shall dream dreams. There is a difference between prophecy, visions, and dreams. They are different. Prophecies are revelation knowledge of God. Prophecies are the revelation knowledge of God for every dispensation. Prophecies are the revelation knowledge of God for every dispensation. Visions are the things that will happen in every generation. Dreams are the things that will happen in another generation. So young men and young women shall see the things that will happen in their generation. But old men and women in the spirit shall see the things that will happen in another generation. So you can see the things that will happen in your generation because you are a young man, because you are a young woman. But the fathers in the kingdom will see the things that will happen in the next generation. So fathers can see the things that will happen in the next 20 generations by the mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit. So it is the voice of the Holy Spirit that will reveal this thing unto them. The voice of the Holy Spirit will reveal these mysteries unto them. So the voice has a guiding ability. The voice will guide you. As the voice guide Agabus, the voice guided Agabus in Acts of the Apostles chapter 11. So Prophet Agabus was able to operate in the office of the prophet by engaging the voice of the Holy Spirit. Apostle Paul received direction by the voice of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit forbade him from entering into some cities, and that same Holy Spirit also guided him into some cities so that he can preach the gospel, and that Spirit is still speaking expressly to us, telling us about what will happen in the last days according to 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the later times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits. Giving it to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. So the Spirit is still speaking. And you should be able, and you must be able to perceive the voice of the Spirit. You perceive it so that you can change your word. You become a leader in your word. You have this guiding ability. You can become a counselor by the voice of the Spirit. There are seven manifestations of the Holy Spirit, seven dimensions of the Holy Spirit, according to Isaiah chapter 11. the Spirit of the Lord God, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. These are the seven dimensions of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of counsel is one of the dimensions of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit is one, but there are seven dimensions of this one Spirit. We are carrying a single Spirit, but there are seven dimensions of this one Spirit. So counseling is one of the dimensions of the Holy Spirit. So we become a good counselor on earth by the help of the voice of the Holy Spirit, the guiding ability. So John the Beloved received this guiding ability at the islet of Patmos. He said, I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day. In the book of Revelation. So he received the mysteries in the book of Revelation by the voice of the Holy Spirit, not by his encounter with an angel, by the voice of the Holy Spirit. So he was carried in the realm of the Spirit into different realms where he received the revelations of the things that will happen in the last days. The guiding ability. You need the guiding ability of the Holy Spirit, and you have access to this guiding ability through the voice. I mean the mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. In Hebrews chapter 3 verse 7 and 8, it says, wherefore as the Holy Ghost saith, today if ye will hear his voice, if ye will hear his voice, harden not your heart as in the provocation in the day of temptation in the wilderness. If ye will hear his voice, harden not your heart. So the spirit is speaking as the Holy Ghost said. So the Holy Ghost has been speaking, and the Holy Ghost will continue to speak. The Holy Ghost spoke in the past. The Holy Ghost spoke by the mouth of David concerning what will happen to Judas. The Holy Ghost spoke by the mouth of the fathers in the old dispensation, things that will happen in the new dispensation. So the Holy Ghost is speaking. Is still speaking in this current dispensation. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart. Hallelujah. Harden not your heart today. So that is a warning. So the Holy Spirit has a warning ability. The voice of the Holy Spirit has a warning ability. Point number three, right? The voice of the Holy Spirit has a warning ability. Today, not tomorrow, it is today. So you need today to do exploits today. There is a voice for today, and there is a word for today. Your ears must be open in the realm of the Spirit to pick the words for today. The psalmist also saw this mystery in Psalm 95. The word for today, you need it today. So your ears must be open every day in order to receive the word for every day. Isaiah said in Isaiah chapter 55 verse 6, seek ye the Lord while he may be found, call ye upon him while he is near. You call upon him while he is near, you seek him. Because there is a warning for you. Your ears must be open to receive this warning. Because today is our accepted time, and is the acceptable time for salvation, for deliverance, for victory. For victory. In 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 2, it says, for he said, I have heard thee in the time accepted, and in the day of salvation, have I succored thee? Behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. Now is the accepted time, not tomorrow. Not tomorrow, now. So there is a word for now, and your ears must be open to pick the word for now. We as the spiritual Israel have access to the voice of the Holy Spirit. The voice of the Holy Spirit is the voice of God. And this voice of the Holy Spirit will give us access to the sure mercies of David. We have access to the everlasting covenant, because this voice of the Holy Spirit shall reveal unto us the content of this everlasting covenant, so that our destiny will be bright on it. Hallelujah. This voice will lead us in all things and give warnings. It's giving warnings. In John chapter 10 verse 3, Jesus said to him, "The porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice," his warnings, "and he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out." Leadeth them out. So the sheep hear his voice. The sheep hear the warning of the master. So God is our shepherd. So the Holy Spirit in this dispensation is our shepherd. The Spirit of God is our spiritual shepherd. And our ears must be open to the voice of the Spirit of God, to pick the voice of the Spirit of God. Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. They hear my warnings." My sheep hear my warnings. My sheep hear my warnings. So there are warnings coming. God will warn us by the voice of the Holy Spirit. John the Beloved said in Revelation chapter 3 verse 20, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and will sup with him and he with me." So our heart must be loose. Our heart must be softened so as to receive the warning of God. Hallelujah. Some people's hearts are so hard to receive the things of God. Some hearts are so hard to receive the things of God. Some hearts are like stones. They are just like stones. They cannot receive the things of God. I don't just know why. You break your heart. You soften your heart so that you can receive the things of God. If your heart is not open to receive the things of God, you will definitely perish like Nebuchadnezzar. And God hardened the heart of Nebuchadnezzar for punishment. God also hardened the heart of Pharaoh for destruction. So if your heart is not open and not softened to receive the things of God, you are on the path to destruction. You are definitely on the pathway to destruction. Your heart must be loose. Your heart must be open to receive the things of God so that you can prosper on it. You receive the warning ability, and you also have this warning ability. You receive your caution. The Spirit will caution you, give you advice, and give you notice. The Spirit will give you some notification concerning the things that will happen ahead. The Spirit will show you regions of dangers, will guide you into all things, give fear warnings to you, and give you red signals of danger zone. Whenever you are in that danger zone, the Spirit will give you the red signals, the alert, and the advice that you need per time, the information that you need, the information that you need, and the Spirit will remind you of the past warnings. The Spirit of God, the voice of the Spirit will remind you of the past warnings. The Spirit will reprove you and admonish you. You receive your counsel, the exhortation per time, and the reproof that you need for your generation by the voice of the Holy Spirit. This Spirit will also prepare you for the best. not just prepare you, but the Spirit will prepare you for the best by offering you a word of caution per time. The Spirit can also threaten you so that you will respond to the call of God. You respond to the calling of God. Whenever the Spirit threatens you, the Spirit can threaten you. The Spirit will threaten you. You just have this mind, troubled mind, because the Spirit will trouble your mind till you respond to the call of God. The Spirit can also forbid you. That is a warning. Do not go to that region. That is a danger zone. The Spirit will forbid you. The Spirit will give you some prediction, because the Spirit is a seer. Hallelujah. The Spirit is a seer. The Spirit will give you some prediction. And by giving you this prediction, the Spirit will prepare you for the things ahead. You receive special recommendations by the voice of the Holy Spirit. And some suggestions will be dropped. Some suggestions will be dropped in your mind. Through the warning ability of the voice of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit will hint you about things that will happen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The warning ability of the Holy Spirit. You need it in this dispensation. The warning ability. Warning ability. As the Spirit of God is flashing the green light, the Spirit is also flashing the red light. The Spirit will flash the green light. That shows that you can go. That shows that you can fulfill that mandate. That shows that you can go to that land and occupy the land. But whenever the Spirit flashes the red light, the Spirit is warning you that you must not go there. You must not go there. Stop there. The Spirit will ring the bell, and you hear it by your spiritual ears. You perceive this by your spiritual ears. You pick these sounds by your spiritual ears. By your spiritual ears. And the Spirit will also make you to hear the voice of the wolves. The Spirit will open your ears to perceive the voice of the wolves, so that you can know, by giving you eye signs, and opening your ears to the things of God. Opening your ears to the things of the Spirit, you receive your warnings. You receive your warnings by the ministry of the Holy Spirit. Specifically the voice of the Holy Spirit. So the mystery of the voice of the Holy Spirit is needed in this current dispensation. And through the voice of the Holy Spirit, you have access to the speaking ability of the Holy Spirit, the guiding ability, and the warning ability. So you are carrying three ability: the speaking ability, the guiding ability, and the warning ability. You can become a good orator on it. Excellent orator on it. You can become a counselor on it. You guide, and you become a leader on it. You guide them, you lead them, and you warn them. You are a counselor on it. You show direction, because you are carrying the compass of God on it. You are carrying the compass of God on it. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.